Welcome to the 91st edition of Marix Maritime News. The headlines on Monday, the 8th of November 2021. Despite strong increase in seafarer vaccination, crew change difficulties linger. ITF calls for urgent need to make industry safe for women. Ship operating cost moderating, but inflationary concerns remain. Global economy stuck in one of history's biggest traffic jams. Maersk reports 68% rise in revenue. The most positive trend reported in November is the 9.9% increase in seafarer vaccinations, from 31% in October to 41%. Yet challenges remain, with governments demanding seafarers be vaccinated with particular vaccines to ensure crew changes. This has resulted in seafarers ending up being over-vaccinated with different vaccines. The IDF says the recent report of a sexual assault of a US Merchant Marine Academy cadet during her sea training brings shame on the shipping industry and underlines the urgent need for action to eliminate sexual violence in the workplace. Sadly, this is not an isolated incident, but a reality for many seafarers, both male and female, regardless of flag or company, said ITF Seafarers Section Women's Representative Lena Dyring.
Further to the same, as a pioneer woman in this field, I am able to empathize with all those women serving in the maritime sector. The IMO had for long aligned itself with the UN SDG number 5, that is gender equality. However, the recent spat of incidents of sexual assault on women serving on ships is raising a lot of question about the integrity of intent in the maritime industry towards achieving a safe workplace for women at sea. Also, the incident is not limited to women only, but spreads across all genders. As we are moving towards a civilized society which believes that economies cannot achieve its full potential unless we provide a safe ecosystem for individuals to explore their potential and the right opportunity such that they can give back to the society. We need to educate all individuals to be more respectful towards all genders and also have a strict code of conduct on board ships to eliminate such incidents.
Operating cost inflation has slowed this year as some COVID-19 related expenses unwound, and high vessel earnings encouraged some owners to postpone non-essential maintenance work. But wider macroeconomic developments are raising inflationary risk, as will decarbonization initiatives.
Good to hear that wider inflationary costs of shipping are under control, especially that of COVID-induced. Unfortunately, we can't be delinked from the macroeconomics of the world and its trade, which is also driven or influenced by inflation. Basically, inflation is a part of economics. When the money is being shared by more people, its value drops. Governments print more money. And when you say money, it includes floating cash, credits and everything else. And we had many changes from Bretton Woods, delinking US dollar from gold, India flying out gold and stabilizing, and governments doling out money to raise consumption demand. All this are basic economics, which itself is to a large extent unproven. But coming to the topic again, can we be delinked from macroeconomics? It's quite doubtful. But I would even say we are beneficiaries because it drives trade, it changes competitive advantage of costs, and it even reflects on our own costs, whether it is fuel or salaries or port costs or basically even capital costs, because that is the cheapest right now. Capital costs money for nothing, really.
The Maritime CEO virtual conference is back celebrating gender diversity, change makers, and sustainable solutions. This time, we're sharing more voices, spreading more awareness, and building better inclusivity. This is your chance to virtually meet some of the biggest names in the industry. Through this conference, you have the opportunity to gain insight and hear amazing stories from world-renowned speakers. Some of the big names are Dr. Cleopatra Dubia Henry from World Maritime University, Lei Kun Kwa from Maritime and Port Authority of Singapore, Lois Zabrocki from International Seaways Inc., Katharina Stanzel from Intertanko, Subkora Kuma from APM Terminals, Subdon Kuptanagu from Kuptanagu Shipping, Jillian Carson Jackson from the Nautical Institute, Despina Theo Du Siu from Tata Theo Maritime. Last year's conference brought together 70 speakers and over 1,500 attendees from around the globe. This year is only going to get better. We'll explore the importance of having women as part of the company boards. We'll celebrate the first women who have paved the way in the industry to ensure a better tomorrow for all the other women out there. Can we work on a possibility of a hybrid maritime industry in the future? There are also curated sessions on entrepreneurs, next-generation family business owners, and fueling female entrepreneurs, where we bring together key stakeholders together for insightful discussion. We will also be activating the next generation to engage with maritime CEOs and to bring in Tools Global Ocean and Energy Community from across 25-plus countries. This year, we also play matchmaker. We ask a series of questions that will help connect you to the right person to enhance your networking experience. You still have the option of networking with anyone you'd like through our directory. Just think of the connections you could make. So what are you waiting for? Register today.
New economic indicators quantify what's apparent to the naked eye across much of the planet. In supermarkets with empty shelves, ports where ships are backed up far offshore, or car plants where output is held back by a lack of microchips. Looming over all of these are price tags rising on almost everything.
In a rare advisory, the Chinese government has advised its citizens to store daily essentials for emergency needs. The US commentators have gone on to say that empty shelves is the new normal. This is clearly a failure of supply chain resilience. While every problem is multidimensional, there are core issues and there are root causes. And failure of logistics and logistics infrastructure is certainly one of them. While the defense forces and the government are sensitive to the logistics for country's defense and security, we have also seen the governments are sensitive about energy security and logistics for the same. However, we have seen there is a lack of understanding and essential sensitivity for ensuring supply chain resilience and robust logistics infrastructure for international trade. This becomes even more serious in an interdependent world where we depend on the whole world for sourcing and for markets. This is one area where all the policymakers, big corporations, and international trade in general has to work together to ensure that this doesn't repeat again.
Copenhagen-based Maersk has said revenue grew nearly 68% in the third quarter to a record high $16.6 billion, up from $9.9 billion in the same three-month period last year. It reported profits of $5.5 billion, up from $947 million in the period last year. CEO Soren Skou said, in the ongoing exceptional market situation with high demand in the US and global disruptions to the supply chains, we have continued to increase capacity and expand our offerings to keep cargo moving for our customers. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you for watching. See you next Monday.